Welcome to online class of Dhore Alifuddin Fazil Degree Madrasa. Dear students, honorable guardians, and all the viewers, good morning. In this COVID situation, I would like to request all of the guardians to take care of your children, and according to your ability, you should give them proper food, nutritious food, and you should take them so that they can continue their study, because in these situations some students can roam, and if you do not care them, they will depart from the education. Today I am Mohammad Shafiul Alam, lecturer in English. I will take the class of class 9 and 10, subject English paper 1. And my today's topic is unit 5, nature and environment. Unit 5, nature and environment, that means prakriti ebong poribesh. All of you know that Bangladesh is facing some natural disaster, and Bangladesh is the victim of climate change. That's why we should keep our environment clean, and we have to be careful about our nature and environment. We should take care of nature. We should plant more trees so that we can get fresh oxygen. Our today's lesson is the greed of the roaring rivers. The greed of the roaring rivers, all of you know that Bangladesh is a riverine land, but sometimes river is in our country, they can be both our blessing and they can be both our curse. Sometimes river addition makes our people landless, homeless, so that we should take proper steps against the river addition. Our government is concerned about this. Next, we also have to be careful. We should not do that type of work that can destroy our environment, and we can live in a risky life. Dear students of 9 and 10, after the lesson, you will be able to comprehend and summarize text, and from your text, sometimes in question, you have to ask question answers, multiple choice question. And sometimes in 9 and 10, they are filling the gaps. Here, before starting the passage, I have given you some words. I would like to introduce the words with you. Here we'll find some words that means slum. Slum means bosti. You have to remember this, slum means bosti. Embankment, you will find another word, embankment. Embankment means bath. Bath. Every cities in our country, there is an embankment so that the embankment can protect the city. Next word, tremble. Tremble. Tremble means kappa. Tremble means kappa. Unsteady, you will find another word, unsteady. You have to remember this word, and you have to, if you can, if you want to increase your vocabulary power, you have to know the vocabulary, the meaning of the word, sometimes synonym antonyms, and the Bengali meaning, it will easy for you. Unsteady. Unsteady means austhir. Austhir. Next you find another word, shatter. Shatter means churno bichurno kora. Next another word you will find, turmoil. Turmoil, ashanti. Erosion. Erosion means bhangon. Our today's passage is about river erosion, nodi bhangon. Consume, you will find another word. Consume means grass kora. Next you will find demolish. Demolish means dhongsho kora. Here we will find another word, reality. Reality means bastobata. Ba amra jeta face kori, everyday face. Harsh. Harsh means hard or corpush. Dear students, open your page 56 you will find lesson 1, the greed of the roaring rivers. Greed means loaf, roaring, gorjon, river. Nodir, lobhi nodir gorjon. We have many mighty rivers like Padda, the Meghna, the Jamuna, Brahmaputra, Arialkha, Mata Mohuri, Shangu, Karnafuli, this type of rivers. Sometimes these rivers is blazing in our country, but sometimes it can be a curse because of river erosion. Our today's passage is about this type. Here's a victim named Meherjan. We have many Meherjan in our country. We should not want to see this, but the erosion of the rivers make our people landless, homeless, and they grasped our property. That's why we have to, our government should protect the river and should protect the embankment so that our country people cannot become homeless, landless. That's why I will go through the passage. You will see the passage. Meherjan lives in a slum on the Shirazganj town protection embankment. That means Meherjan, a woman, she lives in a slum, that type of choto dhoroner ek dhoroner ghor jeta hote pare onek shomoy nodir pare manush ghor bari toiri kore shekhane tara bader moddhe tader jomi jema na thakar karone tara toiri kore shekhane dekha jay sei tin polythin ba onnanno chhala ba onnanno jinish diye tara ghor toiri kore thake tara they are very helpless. So this type of woman, Meherjan, a woman lives in a slum on the Shirazganj town protection embankment. Shirazganj shohor rakha bhat. Shohor rakha bhader upor Meherjan bash kore. Her polythene roof shelter, here we find her house is made of polythene roof. Polythene sheet dara ba polythene dara tar toiri looks like a case. Kemon dekha jay tar bari ta hocche খাঁচার মতো দেখা যায়, তার বাড়িটা অনেকটা কিসের মতো দেখা যায়, খাঁচার মতো। হে উই ফাইন্ড হেয়ার হিজ এজ, শি ইজ নিয়ারলি 45 বাট লুকস মোর দ্যান হার এজ, শি ইজ অনলি 45 বাট পোভার্টি হার প্রবলেমস মেক হিম মোর ওল্ড, তাকে আরও বয়স্ক দেখাচ্ছে। 45 বছর তার বয়স, কিন্তু এই তাকে 45 হলেও তাকে দেখায় হলো আরও বেশি বয়সের মতো দেখা যায়। In front of her shelter, shelter means ashray, tar ashray kache ba tar barir kache, she is trying to make a fire, she is trying to make a fire to cook the day's only meal. She in Bangladesh we eat 3 times major food, but she is very helpless. That's why I think she cannot manage her 3 meals in a day. She is trying to make fire to make the day's only meal. She diner ekmatro ahar she toiri korteche ranna korar jonno she chesta korteche. Her weak hands tremble. She is 45 but he is helpless. That's why she is trying to make fire but her hands are trembling. Tar hat kapteche. Manush jokhon obhabe thake, manusher jokhon samasya thake, তখন সহজ কাজও তাদের কাছে সহজ মনে হয় না, সেই জন্য তার হাত কাঁপতেছে। হার উইক হ্যান্ডস ট্রেম্বল অ্যাজ শি অ্যাড সাম ফলেন লিভস, শি ইজ ট্রাইং টু মেক ফায়ার উইথ দ্য হেল্প অফ ফলেন লিভস, পাতা দিয়ে সে জ্বাল দেওয়ার চেষ্টা করতেছে। অ্যানি স্ট্র, স্ট্র মিন্স খড়, আমরা ইন ভিলেজ স্ট্র মিন্স আমরা ইন আওয়ার লোকাল ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ সামটাইমস উই কল খ্যার, in proper meaning that means khor. Khor means dhaner je obosishta dhan gach je thake seikhan diye amra jeta byabohar kori seta ke amra khor bole thaki. To fire, that means she is trying to make fire with the help of fallen leaves. The English is not here very difficult. If you try, you will, I think, will be able to understand this. The whispering wind from the river Jamuna makes the fire unsteady. The whispering, nodir pare, if we sit in a river, by the side of a river, there will be a gentle breeze. We feel it, but in the case of Meherzan, the breeze, the wind cannot make him a proper firing. That's why she is facing some troubles to cook her food. That's why Meherzan is trying to make fire, but the fire is not properly. The whispering wind, midumando batas ba je shirshir batas jeta ashe shei batas tar agun take thik moto jolte diteche na, because she is using straw and fallen leaves. Sometimes the leaves are wet, that's why fire cannot easily. The whispering wind from the river Jamuna makes the fire unsteady. You find the word unsteady, I have told you before. Unsteady means asthir, tar agun take asthir kore dicche. The dancing of the flames, dance, you know, nach, but here dancing flames means ognishika. Agun jokhon jole tumra dekhe thakbe, agun aste aste jole othoba agunar shomoy jore jole, agun kintu shojha bhabe jole na, agun onekta aguner nacher moto mone hocche ekhane. Here the writers write down in this way: the dancing of the flames reminds Meherzan of the turmoil in her life. The fire is unsteady. Meherzan is also unsteady because of the fire, among she is remembering her past, how she was solvent, but the river has grasped her all dreams, had shattered her dreams. That's why Meherzan is remembering his past that was full of happiness, that was full of enjoyment. But this situation, she is very unsteady, like the flame of the fire. Not long ago, Meherzan had everything. Here are the words: not long ago, Meherzan had everything. That means a family, cultivable land and cattle. Meherzan was not poor at that once upon a time, but the river has grasped her dreams, had shattered her dream. Once upon a time, Meherzan has lot of things. That means Meherzan had happiness in her life. He had a family, cultivable land, and cattle. In the village, if you have all type of these things, I think you can lead a better life. That's why Meherzan was also happy. But the mighty rivers, here the embankment of Sirajganj. Sirajganj, in Sirajganj, our mighty river Jamuna has flown through the town. That's why Meherzan is unsteady. Meherzan is now helpless, poor. River, the erosion of Jamuna consumed all her landed property gradually. Meherzan has lost all of her property in the mighty river Jamuna. In Bangladesh, many people like Meherzan. So that I always request our government to protect the embankment, to protect our people. Our government is taking some steps. Inshallah, in near future, I think these people will develop and we have no river erosion. Our river will be our all time, will be our source of fish, source of protein, and source of that will be our blazing. The erosion of the Jamuna consumed all her landed property gradually. In it a day to demolish Meher's house. River, mighty river Jamuna, a day to demolish her house. Dhongsho kore diyeche tar ghar, trees, vegetable garden, and the bamboo bush. That means Meherzan had all things that we need in a to lead a life. The mighty river Jamuna demolish Meher's house, trees, vegetable garden, and all the bamboo bush. Tar bari, tar gachpala, shak shobjir bagan, ebong bajdar, shob kichu ek dine churno bichurno kore diyeche. She had a happy family once. Once upon a time, Meherzan had a happy family. Over the years, she lost her husband and her family to disease. That cruel hunger and poverty brought to the family. whenever her husband has died, poverty has come to her family. That's why now Meerjan is helpless, landless. She needs, we should assist Meerjan, and we should assist like this type of people. Our rich people should come forward to help the people. In this way, we can remove our poverty from the society. And dear students, you should also try to help this type of people. If you have ability, then you can help the poor people, landless people. Our government, we know this year is the Mujib Borsho. Our government has announced that no person will be homeless. Every person will have a home, every person will have a address, every person will have a residence. Our government is trying to materialize this day by day. Inshallah, near future, I think we will find no homeless people, no landless people, and Bangladesh will be a happy country, and Bangladesh will raise his hands on the world map like a developed country, not a developing country. Now she is the only one left to live on with the loss and the pain. In the loss and the pain, Meherjan is only people to live. That's why the greedy Jamuna has shattered her dreams and happiness. I have told you before that the mighty river Jamuna has consumed Meherjan's land, property, and the bamboo bush and all her property. There are 1,000 others waiting to share the same fate like Meherjan. We know in our society, river erosion is very acute problem in our country. That's why many people are facing the lack of Meherjan day by day, and we should take, our government should take proper steps to protect them. Our government is trying to cope with the situation, but in this COVID situation, we have to face another problem, a lot of problem. That's why it is very difficult for the government to solve all the problems. The rich people of the country should come forward to help the poor people, so that we can make a happy Bangladesh. Bangladesh is a land of rivers that affect its people. We know Bangladesh is a riverine country. River is river is all around of us, and river is the source of our many kinds. If we use the rivers, we can transport easily. That's why, dear students, I will solve the problem of the question answer and MCQ answer and all the questions in my next class. Today, I think you will be able to find the passage. You should read the passage thoroughly and try to understand the meaning of the words, and you should try to underline the keywords of the passage, and you have to read the passage properly. And next class, I will answer the last part of the passage and question answer, MCQ, and fill in the gaps. Okay, dear students, you should keep well, you should keep hygiene, take care of yourself, take care of your parents. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for viewing me. Thank you.